I think by now you have fallen in love with Francis Bacon. Now, this is the 16th essay of envy. So we, as usual, we will see the main points. The main points are first, so there are two affections. Affections means, you know, feelings, you get the strong feelings, he says. One is love and the other is envy. Both have quality, same quality. They are very fascinating, see, and also they are bewitching. Bewitching means what? This, if you are gripped by this love or envy, you will be drawn into that. That is bewitched means. You will be drawn into that. And there will be a lot of imagination, wishes, dreams, suggestions. And especially when you see the object of your envy or love, then these things will be doubled. You envy somebody, and then if you see that person, then all kinds of feelings will come to you. Or when you are in love, you find that person, then they also you have good dreams, imagination, suggestions and so on. So that's the point one. So we can say that love and envy, they are very, so they are affections, both fascinating, interesting also, and bewitching. Bewitching means you will be drawn into that, like a pool of water, you know. Then you will be drawn into that. A whirlpool, not a pool, but a whirlpool. You will be drawn into that. That's the thing. Second, what the scriptures say about envy? Scriptures say, holy books say, it is evil eye. And astrologers say it is evil aspect. Evil aspect. Evil eye, or and astrologer says evil aspect. Envy is a very, you can say it is an evil affection. Anyway, it's not a good one. Now, when does envy strike? Envy strikes when somebody is triumphant. That's the third point. Envy strikes when triumphant, so victorious now, triumphant. Say, example, you know, you come to know that your classmate has scored very high marks. You will say congratulations, but out of what? That envy is. Because you got the first try. Yes. So this general aspects or ideas about envy. That both are very strong emotions or affections, you can say. And then what the scripture says, it is evil eye. What the astrologers say, it is evil aspect. Then when does actually this happen? When somebody becomes successful, extraordinary, brilliant, see, triumphant. As I told you just now about sometimes your own classmates, see that. He may be your friend, but a few seconds. It will take some time to rationalize. This is a fact, no doubt about that. Isn't it? Yes. Now we come to the two levels of envy. One is public envy and the other is private envy. So he deals, he spends quite a lot of time on private envy. Private envy, he says, who envies whom? That's the next point. Private envy. Public and company visa, so that's private envy. And there you see, who envies whom? Who envies whom? Say that. Persons of extraordinary virtue, that nobody will envy. Mother Teresa, Mahatma Gandhi, Vinoba Bhave, no envy. Then, people who are busy and inquisitive, called player pressure, there are people who envy. See that? There's the, what is happening? They want to collect news. No? Not for appreciating, but to find out if there is something wrong. That's the thing. I know a friend of mine, who used to write the stories, and people would say, he's plagiarizing, or stealing from others. Actually, he had an original genius, and he knew he could write, he has got the ability. But people will not accept him. They say, that is because he has stolen from somewhere, they will say. So that is pressure or inquisitive. That is this, people, noble people, you know, men of noble birth, they will envy people who come up in life, because they think that there will be a challenge. Already established nobility, or you can say, people of noble birth, when they see the inferior people or the low class people are rising up to their level, definitely they will feel envy, no doubt. Then deformed persons, eunuchs, bastards, old men, they envy others. The deformed men, oh, he can walk, I can't. Maybe it's like that. I see that there are some people who want to excel in everything, but they cannot excel in anything. See that? About Andrian, it has been said that he wanted to become a poet, an artificer, an architect and whatnot. But none of this, he will be shining. Therefore, what happens? He will envy all these people. And the most envy strikes at the nearest person. Your relatives, near relatives, own brothers. Understand? Person in the same family. There is a Bertrand Russell says, envy travels to the nearest person. This is a fact. So these are the persons who envy others. Very well-known, eminent, virtuous persons, they will not envy anybody. Because they are a class by themselves. Mother Teresa, no envy for others. Or Vinoba Vasudeva, Mahatma Gandhi and so on. They cannot envy. But who are the people who actually envy others? Player pressure means inquisitive people. They want to know what is concerned. Second is noble people, that is lords, you can say, or high society people. When they see low society people coming up, they will envy at them. And next type, third is deformed, any defect, you know, physically challenged and so on. Sometimes poor people envy rich people. Another is that there are certain people who want to excel in everything. Such people, they envy other people. And sixth and the most important is near relatives. So these are the people who envy others. Now, who are the objects of envy? Who are the objects? Means people who are envied. Not people who envy, but people who are envied. One, I say there are many people, say, for example, people don't envy persons of eminent virtue. Already we have seen. They also don't. People don't envy kings. But there is no comparison. The basis for envy is comparison. You cannot compare. A citizen cannot compare himself with a king. So, no king. But kings will, definitely. King of one country will, or nation, or country such as kingdom, will envy king of another king. Then, no, men of noble birth, by nature they are gentle, they won't envy. And then, if somebody comes up in life, step by step, nobody will envy. And then, people like, say, great achievers, like Ulysses, don't envy, because you cannot reach them, that's the reason. So, the second part, objects of envy is it. There are half a dozen people you don't envy at all. Why? Because of their excellence. So like the persons of eminent virtue, kings, people of noble birth, people who advance step by step. People really appreciate those hardworking men. And also, like Ulysses, there are people, extraordinary people, no envy. Envy cannot do anything with them. Nobody wants to envy us. And who are the people actually, the people who sudden rise people. Till yesterday, yes, poor, but tomorrow you find them. Today you find him building bungalows and all those things. Something like that. Understand? Then, extraordinary fortune. Some people are, whatever they do, whatever they touch, it will be midas touch. It will become gold. So such people, they are objects of envy. And then, there are other people who, when they become rich, they become very proud, insolent, arrogant. They pomp and show. People will envy. So they are objects of envy. Sudden people cannot envy, like kings for example. But this is sudden rich people, extraordinary fortunate people, and also people who show off, ostentatious wisdom. They're proud and showy, pomp and show. So people are envied. So when you become very rich, you don't show this. When you build a house of 6,000 square feet, 15,000 square feet, then do it slowly. Overnight if you do, definitely you will be an object of envy. These are the points about private envy. Private envy is person to person. About public envy. Public envy is this dissatisfaction with, say for example, discontentment, that's the word used here. So ministers or officers. Public envy is good, he says, because it will limit their arrogance. Or it will bridle, control their arrogance. Primarily, extraordinarily blind person. Some people start gossiping against him. Naturally, it will reach his eye, his ears. Then he will think, that is such a minus point. So he will become a bit humble. So public envy is good in a way. It can control the extraordinary powers enjoyed by certain officers and also ministers. That is, finally, that's the conclusion. So these are the main points. We'll start reading from tomorrow. So remember what I said. Love and public envy. Fifth one is public envy. Public envy. Public envy affects those who hold office, public officers. That is states, minister, and that's good, he says. It's a kind of limiting or controlling their unnecessary, or you can say, extraordinary power that they're enjoying, and also their pride. It's good, that's what he says. Alright, so we have first love and envy, their affections, both fascinating and then bewitching. And when you see the objects, you know, all kinds of things will come to your mind. That's it. Say the suggestion, imagination, dream, but no. Then, what does the scripture say? Scripture say it is evil. Astrology say it is evil aspect. Envy strikes when? When somebody is successful. What is private envy? Private envy, person to person. So, for example, who envy others? Persons of exceptional virtue, they don't envy anybody. So, but play pressure people, busy inquiring about other people, inquisitive people, they envy others. Noble people, they envy new rise people, people coming up in life. Deformed, defective person, they envy. If you are trying to excel in many things, you will be envy all those persons who have already excelled in those things. You want to become a poet, you cannot do it, so you envy poets. You want to become a dramatist, you cannot do it, so you envy them. You want to become an architect, you cannot become. So you want to become a painter, you cannot. So you envy Michelangelo. Listen. Then near relatives. Who are the subjects of envy? Means objects whom people envy. Sudden rich people, highly fortunate people, and also those who show pomp and show. They are envy. Who are not envy? Persons of eminence, virtue, kings, persons of noble birth. Means they are like that. So there's no point in that. Then those who advance in life step by step, and also exceptionally gifted persons, achievers like Ulysses, they don't envy. Hector, nobody envies him. Achilles, nobody envies him. Because you cannot reach anywhere near. That's the reason. And then you have public envy, that is officers of a king, or a ministers of a king, or a state. That's good, he says, because it's a kind of limiting their power. And lastly, it's a conclusion. There is a conclusion. So, this is the plan of the essay. We'll start reading this essay in detail from tomorrow. This is a very famous essay of envy. All the essays are very famous. And if you want to get, see, it's ideas, you know, you should read Francis Bacon. Whether it is prescribed or not, it's a great intellectual pleasure. Okay, see, but before that, put out the killer virus, let us sing in a chorus, shut out what is past, put up a tough fight, and flush out the killer. Bye, have a nice day.